Hello learners, I am Madhuri Hooda from Department of Education, Maharishi Dhan University, Rohtak. With the greetings of the day, let us discuss a very important issue, the use of open educational resources. In this module, which is licensing of open educational resources as a learning session of our next module, here we will conceptualize licensing of open educational resources, open educational licensing policy, conditions of licensing under Creative Commons, and various licenses of using open educational resources. Learning outcomes of this present module are, learners will be able to conceptualize licensing of open educational resources. They will be able to understand open educational licensing policy. They will be able to understand various types of licensing related with OERs, open educational resources. They will be able to differentiate between various categories of Creative Commons licenses. They will be able to understand the advantage of licensing the educational resources. So now we'll discuss about the concept of licensing. Now, see, digital technologies are emerging and have immense potential for dissemination of knowledge. Copyright laws come into action to determine the legality of such knowledge dissemination. There are some mandatory licenses which are available in the copyright laws of each country, but they cannot be generalized for others. Digital dissemination of knowledge has great potential for copyright infringement, and in most of the instances, the user is not able to use or communicate copyrighted materials. Even the fast pace of knowledge creation and dissemination doesn't give the option to the users, neither it is convenient to obtain permission from the author before using the content. Through the mechanism of open access and e-commerce mechanism, the process of obtaining permission from the author becomes automated. Apart from the economic right of the author in the copyrighted material, there are moral and personal rights also, which are considered inherent in the copyrighted material. These rights also exist independently of the economic rights of the owner of the copyrighted material, such as use or reproduce or remix, which is given by the permission of the author. It is an idea to ask copyright owners about their willingness to distribute their material and license out on the philosophy of increasing the use of educational content and creating a common pool of knowledge. Creative Commons is a non-profit organization in San Francisco and sponsored by many individuals and the organizations aimed at building of distributed knowledge commons by encouraging copyright owners to use their educational material by licensing through open content licensing guidelines. In the last decade, tremendous change is seen in the way knowledge is constructed and disseminated. The communication of thought, idea, or any educational content has become very easy and it is made free of cost. This capacity of communication of knowledge has multiplied manifold by the broadband networks that facilitate enriched text, audio, and videos to be communicated from any corner of the world. Along with these developments in technologies, social practices also got adopted for new type of environment. User and peer constructed knowledge in a collaborative manner is created by thousands of users. For example, we can see Wikipedia, which is an online encyclopedia, Flickr, online photo library, which is also user generated, and a very common social community, MySpace, which is a social networking place. Open content licensing is a legal framework that provides copyright owners with the facility to share their educational content over the internet network for the use all over the world and thereby create a legal seamless access over the internet. It is like a call for the creation of publicly funded knowledge and its free access for them. Open content licenses can be represented in a machine-readable data which facilitate the technology to understand legal provisions related to a particular document. All the digital environment available on the internet is subjected to copyright law. If more flexible process of sharing knowledge in the form of open educational resources is required, we need to understand how the copyright rules operate. Copyright law provides that no one can copy the educational content or transmit it without seeking the permission of the original author. There are some important relaxations granted under this law, such as this permission is granted by the compulsory license, which may be the license free or royalty. This permission is not mandatory when a very small part of educational content is utilized. A number of legal issues are considered while creating open educational resources. Intellectual property rights and copyrights are the significant consideration. Other legal concerns which need consideration are data protection law, illegal content, and accessibility issues. Importance of getting copyright sorted. Let us discuss about this. For instance, if some educational material is shared as an open educational resource and this educational material is not adequately licensed, in this case, reuse of this non-licensed material is copyright infringement. That is why it is very crucial that the producer of the open educational resource content must ensure that to his work and creation a valid license is applied. Open educational licensing policy. Now, how we will see that such type of Creative Commons and other licensing follow such type of open education licensing policy. These are the rules and guidelines that facilitate the creation, use, and updation in the open education resources. These help in inserting open licensing conditions into existing funding systems such as grants, aids, and other agreements that develop educational resources. This is a strong policy agreement about education. When the public is paying for the educational resources, it has the right to access and use the resources free of cost and under legal rights system. Government develop education and educational resources by the funds received from the taxes of the public. So the public should have free access to this material and with a permission to use, adapt and redistribute it at a common platform. The countries and the funding entities wish to create and disseminate knowledge and multiply the impact of their educational developments. These are moving towards an open education licensing policies. Governments and education institutions go in the direction of implementation of open educational licensing policies on the educational content and resources developed with their funding. Strong policy of licensing makes open licensing compulsory. For example, using the Creative Commons Attribution CC BY license that allows the users to avail rights for using the educational resources only when the original author gets acknowledgement. A World Open Educational Resource Congress was held at UNESCO in June 2012, which had a call for governments for the encouragement of open licensing of educational materials developed with the help of public funding. And another World Congress was held in Slovenia in the year 2017 for establishment of normative instrument on open educational resource. A report on open educational resource in 2015 stated that a catalyst for innovation provides policy options to governments such as regulate that all publicly funded materials should be OER by default. Alternatively, the regulation could state that new educational resources should be based on existing open educational resources, where possible reuse needs to be the first principle. A number of countries and organizations have also adopted open education policies related to the creation, remixing, and adaptation of open education resources. Registry list of open policy covers 130 countries and organizations and also includes policy like National Open Licensing Framework. Licensing of open educational resources. Open licensing are the tools which are legal and based on already framed copyright laws. Copyright laws provides the right to the authors to license their own educational content with the license of their choice. David Wille published known software material in the year 1998 under primitive form of open licenses. These primitive form of licenses are now not used because of availability of new alternatives which are more appropriate and adaptable. Free Software Foundation released its first form of open license and was meant to allow for producing open manuals and support materials. It was named at GNU-FTL. It was still in practice and was used by quite popular sites like Wikipedia till Creative Commons license has replaced them. Within open education resource movement, this licensing is not very common because it was not technically simple and loaded with more procedural requirements. In some cases, authors create their open conditions of copyright for their educational resources, but it comes out to be legally challenging in some cases and often not recommended for open educational resources. The attention of the online learning community is now on licensing by Creative Commons and its availability of options of various sets. Licensing by Creative Commons is the most developed licensing approach among the people. It was developed by Larry Lessig of Stanford University in 2001. It provides open licenses for digital material in a user-friendly manner and avoids copyright restrictions. Creative Commons were launched in 2002, and by the year 2006, 45 million web pages had been licensed with Creative Commons. Inspired by the free software movement, the Creative Commons believes that a large, vibrant public domain of information and content is a prerequisite to sustained creativity, and there is a need to proactive enrichment of the public domain by creating a positive right discourse. It does this by creating a set of right discourse and thereby creating a set of licenses to enable open content and collaboration, as well as acting as a database of open content. Creative Commons also serves to educate the public about issues of copyright, freedom of speech and expression, and the public domain. Content developers who seek to apply Creative Commons licenses to their educational content are free to use the conditions of use, modify, adapt, redistribute by opting one of the conditions. Each and every Creative Commons license, except the public domain designation, expect the user to give attribution to the producer of the content, that is the author. Different countries and jurisdictions have different copyright laws, and Creative Commons takes into account all these. It also allows different versions of languages. Creative Commons also makes use of license generator, which helps the user in suggesting the most appropriate license on the basis of the response of the author on the question how their work can be used. Creative Commons license is expressed in three versions to help search for resource licensing. First is Common Deed. This license is in plain language version with supporting icons. And the second is Legal Code. This ensures that license is recognized in a court of law. Digital Code. Due to this, a machine readable translations that helps the search engine to identify work by its terms of use. All the baseline rights of the users lies with the Creative Commons, such as the right to copy, display, distribute, perform publicity or by digital performance, and to change the format of the material as a verbatim copy. All licenses under Creative Commons ensure the rights of the author over the copyrighted material and also grant the copyright freedoms. The users are to seek permission for using the resource in a way that it is restricted according to the licensing conditions. All the copies of the work have copyright notice intact and labeled on them. Either the license get published with the work or it include a link to the license. Licensing terms and conditions are not modifiable in many circumstances. As for lawful use of work, no means is used to restrict other licenses. Now, let us discuss what are the conditions of licensing under Creative Commons. First is attribution by. The user can copy, distribute, display, and perform with the copyrighted work and derivative work based on it, only if they give credit to the way the author has requested for. Second is share alike. Users are allowed to distribute derivative work only under a license identical to the license that governs author's work. Third is non-commercial. Users are allowed to copy, distribute, display, and perform work and the derivative work founded on it only for the non-commercial purpose. Fourth is non-derivative work. Users are allowed to copy, display, distribute, work with verbatim copy of the author's work and the derivative work founded on it is not allowed. Now, let us discuss the various licensing conditions under these main subtypes. Attribution CC BY. This is the most accommodating of all the licenses offered in terms of what the users can do with the author's work licensed under the attribution. This license allows the user to distribute, remix, and build upon author's work even for commercial purpose only if the author gets credit for the original creation. Next is attribution share alike. CC BY SA. This license allows the users to remix and build upon their work even for commercial reasons as long as the original author gets credit for it and the users license their new creations under the same terminology. It is same as open source software licenses. All the new work based on the author's original work will have same licenses and the derivative work are allowed for commercial use. Next is attribution non-derivative, which is denoted by CC by ND. Under this license, the users are allowed to redistribute commercially and non-commercially as long as the resource content is passed along as such and with the credit to the original author. Next is attribution non-commercial, which is denoted as CC by NC. Under this license, the users are allowed to remix, tweak, and build upon the author's work non-commercially, and the new creations must allow acknowledgement of the original author. And the next is attribution non-commercial share alike, CC by NC SA. This license allows users to remix, tweak, and build upon their work non-commercially as long as they credit and acknowledge the original author and license their new creation under identical terms. The users can download and redistribute original work like by NC SA license, but under this license they can also translate, remix, and build new creation based on the original author's work. The new work and new creations based on original author's work will have the same licenses. So by nature, the derivative produced will be of non-commercial nature. Next is attribution non-commercial non-derivative, CC by NC ND. This license is the most rigid and restrictive among the six main types of licenses and allows only redistribution. This license does not allow users to change, tweak, or remix the work of the original author. The users can share the content as long as they acknowledge the and mention the original author and link back to the author. No commercial use is allowed, any condition. Now, let us discuss some licensing considerations under Creative Commons. The most controversial aspect of Creative Commons is the non-commercial clause. Let us discuss what is non-commercial. Non-commercial means, in this context, if we interpret the non-commercial, it means that there should not be any exchange of money for educational material, and is not how the non-commercial term is usually interpreted. Any translation cannot be called commercial when refunding of expenses occur, like for travel as an example. Any transaction is commercial when making profit is the purpose of transaction. CC considers intent to be the primary test of whether the use is non-commercial. If the intent of a particular use is to generate profit, that use is commercial. Under this reasoning, cost recovery is not a commercial use. The COL, Commonwealth of Learning, guidelines of copyright specifically address the concern of NC clause, non-commercial clause. It notes that profit and cost recovery both are different terms. Cost recovery includes the operating cost, and institutions may charge registration fees, recovering cost of material duplication, and other overhead cost of customization, distribution, and duplication of educational materials. Without NC mark, non-commercial mark, state that the learning material they offer may be used to profit stakeholders of any organization by considering all the production cost. And NC marked learning material, non-commercially marked learning material, also pose restriction that any institution or organization will not be able to charge fees or make use of open context for profit. Profit organization may not be able to use material for a non-profit cause. Non-commercially marked materials also make the material incompatible with materials licensed without NC mark. The author who freely releases his educational material may not obviously want others to make money out of it. When the material is freely available on the internet, it is irrelevant to make profit out of that. For making profit, the individual or the institution needs to add appropriate additional value apart from that which is available free to make it a worth for pay. Now let us summarize what we have discussed about licensing of open educational resources yet. Open licenses has facilitated the legal sharing of documents. Open license is a crucial and integral component of open education resources. This intellectual property license grants legal permission to the users over the internet to use, share, adapt, and redistribute the content on a common platform. Educational resource and content is called open education resource only when it is clearly marked as to be in the public domain and have an open license. Sometimes it is believed that sharing an educational content in the form of text or audio or video free of cost online becomes an OER or open education resource, but it is not. It can only become open educational resource when this content is added with an open license. A number of legal issues are considered while creating open educational resources. Intellectual property rights and copyrights are the significant considerations. Other legal concerns which need considerations are the data protection law, illegal content, and accessibility issues. Different countries and jurisdictions have different copyright laws, but Creative Commons takes into account all these. It also allows different versions of languages. Creative Commons also makes use of license generator, which helps the user in suggesting the most appropriate license on the basis of the response of the author on the question how their work can be used. Various types of licensing conditions such as attribution by, share alike, non-commercial, and non-derivative work are provided by Creative Commons, under which various specific licenses for using the open educational resource are being used. Hope you all have enjoyed this learning session. Thanks.